All right, what's up, true believers? Let's get into it. A lot of news has dropped today. A couple of days after Christmas. Merry Christmas, by the way, guys. I didn't really do any kind of posting around Christmas Eve or Christmas because that's the time where you just need to be with your family, and I really believe in that. So you were not going to hear anything from me around there. And maybe if it was like huge news, but nothing really big besides the Captain Marvel like little short trailer came out, but nothing. We didn't really get anything from that, but a lot of stuff has dropped today. Guys, I'm going to take some time to do an innocent plug right here. Not really that innocent, but YouTube. I am literally been working round the clock of just getting the YouTube channel ready for Hard in the Paint podcast. So I'm going to be putting out two videos today. And you know, more in the future. So guys, if you can head on over, all the my listeners from Hard in the Paint podcast, all my faithful listeners, if you can go on to the YouTube channel and search Hard in the Paint podcast and find me, you should see my logo, all that kind of good stuff. I am building and doing a little bit different things now. Again, the reason why you would want to follow my YouTube channel is that I'm going to be doing some content on there visually that you won't see. You won't really see or hear on the podcast. So it's just going to be a little bit tailored differently for YouTube. Some things that I won't necessarily do on the Hard in the Paint podcast on this outlet and these outlets, you know, on like Spotify and Apple and Google Play and Anchor and all those kind of things. It'll just be a little bit tailored for YouTube. So be sure just to be on the lookout for that, guys. Or just, you know, take this time now to go onto YouTube while you're listening to this and hit that subscribe button and the notification bell so you can get all the updates. So I'm putting out two videos today, more so a welcome and introduction video. You'll see some Captain Marvel videos that there. Those are ones that, you know, I'm going to bring on some tracks. That's something that literally is just from the podcast tracks that you'll be hearing like right now. If it is really, really good information, I'm just going to literally bring those tracks over onto the YouTube. So some you'll see tailored to the YouTube channel and some that you'll just be normal what you hear on this outlet too. So enough of all that confusion. So a couple of things that dropped today, guys. We have the Avengers Endgame hero posters. That you can actually find this, me breaking it down a little bit more on my YouTube channel, which that video is uploading, so maybe give it a couple hours or so. But basically, these posters look legit, man. These look amazing. Now, these are official posters from the production studio, and basically, they all look rugged. They all look kind of like that rugged, not rustic, but they kind of like the paint smear. We have all the characters from that were left in Infinity War. You got, you know, Iron Man, Thor, Rocket, Ant-Man, Gamora, Captain Marvel, and so on and so forth. And these look amazing. These really look amazing. Probably the coolest one is Iron Man because his face and helmet takes up pretty much the whole poster, which I kind of go a little bit deeper into that on my YouTube channel where we can kind of look and kind of, you know, assume what the movie and texture is going to be like. But again, this is concept art. You know, this is, posters that are basically not exactly going to tell us the texture and the color of the film. But we already know that it is around the purple, the purple color of the film, which is kind of like a Thanos kind of purple. But again, even though that Thanos is not going to be focused on Avengers 4 Endgame, we already know that, you know, he's retired and all that kind of good stuff. But be sure to check that out on YouTube as well as basically shout out to MCU News and Tweets following them. There's some good resources. Those are the ones that I actually got there. So also another news there, guys. Wong will make an appearance in Avengers Endgame, confirms the actor. So he's actually been getting a lot more work because of his performance in these, blockbuster events. So that's something that basically it has confirmed, kind of you can kind of leak into it where this one news on Reddit was saying that this one user that kind of was breaking down this other trailer that was released somehow. And then, you know how Reddit goes, you put up something and then it's taken out. There was this one scene that was written in there of the viewer that kind of typed out this trailer that Wong was speaking to Doctor Strange's spirit, which that spirit will be going to talking to a huge cosmic entity, a celestial. So again, somebody asked me the other day, what is probably one of the biggest theories? That's one of them, that, you know, we will see the Tribune, or we will see Eternity. So you know, it's one of those, which either one of them, I'll lose my stuff. So that's going to be really, really cool. So even though that, yes, Wong is confirmed, that's like, okay, that's great. No, I don't understand. I just told you, you know, that those little things can give away those things. Just well as, you know, Robert Downey with his Audi commercial, that those things, those are that people kind of slip over and miss. That just gives confirmations. So also over the holidays, we actually got the Avengers Endgame official promo art Renner's Ronin gear there surfaced online. So go and check that out on both YouTube channel as well as the MCU news and tweets on all those. But probably the biggest one that literally just dropped literally like 9 minutes ago, guys, that Kevin Feige has confirmed that development of the MCU films based on X-Men and Fantastic Four characters may begin in mid-2019. Guys, that is huge, okay, for the X-Men fans. And for those that know me, they know that I'm not a big X-Men person, but I have been researching. I have been reading a lot more X-Men comics just to kind of bring in, you know, the House of M, probably one of my favorites, top 10 lists and all that kind of stuff. And that this is huge because, you know, there's so many people that are saying, hey, this type of work, this type of production is long down the road. We're going to get it 4, 6, 8 years down the road. And, you know, even though I was hearing that, you know, not necessarily on the fence, but this is something that I'm like, well, you know what? Maybe not, because we have so many heads working on this. And Kevin Feige's probably been waiting for this stuff, the use of X-Men and Fantastic Four. So we're going to be seeing that possibly in the mid-2019. That's amazing. And even if Fantastic Four will never come to the MC, the cinematic universe, to bring it onto Disney Plus, I'm all for it. I'm all for it. But again, you know, that's a lot of money in those two franchises. So I can't wait for somebody to do Fantastic Four the right way, because there's so many storylines that go through Fantastic Four, so many things that we can possibly see heading on to, like, just like the formation of the Illuminati and all those kind of things. And I'm super excited for that. So that's pretty much it, guys. Pretty short podcast, dropping all these kind of big bombs there, little bombs. But guys, if you are new to the podcast, if you love Marvel, if you love DC, if you love movies and film and all that, comics, all that kind of good stuff, go subscribe to Heart in the Paint podcast on any platform. We're on 11 platforms. We're already over 3,000 subscribers. So I just want to thank you guys for taking the time and just hitting that subscribe button, hitting that notification button on Anchor and Apple and Google and Spotify, all those kind of good things. Guys, go head on over to YouTube. Look me up. Now, again, I don't have a lot of videos, but I am building, guys. So just as you guys have been patient with me on this podcast and growing, we are growing onto the YouTube and tailoring that content on there. So go head on over, hit that subscribe button and the notification button. Guys, please, if you have any comments, comment on the videos on YouTube, or head on over to Anchor, hit that callback button to be featured on a future episode. And once you hit that callback button, it's actually a voice recorder. You can leave your comments that way. So that's probably one of the coolest ways you can do it. So, all right, guys, that's pretty much it. Do not forget to donate, guys, for any of those people that are coming and just want to throw some cash my way that goes towards the channel. Not in my pocket. It goes towards the growth of this channel and quality content. Go to the anchor.fm/hardinthepaintpodcast. That's anchor.fm/hardinthepaintpodcast to give 99 cents, $5, $10, anything you can do. Even though it says a monthly, you don't have to give monthly, but if you can, that is great. So we're pretty much coming up to the 1 year anniversary, guys, and that's when we're releasing our audio series, guys. our 1 year anniversary, we're going to be doing a giveaway as well as releasing the pilot of our audio series, which I have to update you guys. Well, is still on track of release, but we are changing the name. We have to change the name. So be on the lookout for that. We're going to be calling it Oblivion. So really, really excited for that. We're already planning 3 seasons of this audio series, guys. Now, again, we have to have a disclaimer that it is not Marvel or DC back in this. This is a fan-based. But even though we use that terminology of fan-based, we don't want you guys to lose the weight of it, because usually what people do on YouTube and do fan-based, like little stories and alternate, you know, character developments and verses and stuff like that, it doesn't have to carry that much weight. It's just more so, oh, I want to see that. I want to see Hulk versus Superman. This is not that kind of thing. And you're going to pretty much hear that when we release it. So be on the lookout for that. It's going to be around late January. So that's around not only my birthday, but it's around the 1 year anniversary of Heart in the Pain podcast. So be on the lookout, guys. Please hit that favorite button on the Anchor to stay up to date. Please hit the notification button on all the outlets as well as YouTube, so you can get up to date content as well as all the updated information for the giveaways and for this audio series. So the audio series, the Marvel and DC audio series event called Oblivion. We are excited, guys. We are excited. We have so many voice actors, all this production going into it. Super excited. So also, we're going to be updating you guys for the comic book club that is coming out in the new year. So that, be on the lookout for that, which I already have the book, but stay tuned for that as well as on YouTube. So that's going to be a special segment on YouTube. Really, really excited for that. All right, guys, that's pretty much it. I just want to throw all those kind of things out there to get you guys a palate wet for 2019. Super excited for Heart in the Pain podcast and the growth. So all right, guys, thank you for taking the time out of your busy days to hear me rant, as always. Thank you so much. I'm Justin. Thank you for listening to Heart in the Pain. Stay awesome, guys.